Learn how to use your laser machine to make this micro PC case. We'll show you how.
The case in CorelDRAW and Fusion 360, kind of going back and forth to make sure the parts fit together well. In the end, the 2D files were laid out in CorelDRAW and sent to our laser for cutting. This case could be made from a variety of materials, but we went and sized it to cut on 1/8-inch cast acrylic. This was mainly done because we wanted an all-white case with a clear window to show off the insides of the computer. So with a little work, this design would also work for something like 1/8-inch wood, like Baltic birch or an MDF. And then you could paint it or do whatever finish you wanted on it. The PC was designed to be about as small as possible. So a Mini-ITX board was used along with a CPU that supported the board's integrated graphics. And so we basically wanted to dump the graphics card to keep the size really small footprint. In addition, the power supply is also an SFX form factor, so a really small power supply. The design used a framework to build the computer in and panels to basically make it look clean on the outside. The framework, once assembled, had to allow for the fitting of all components, which was a bit of a challenge. This was especially true for the 220mm fans that we were including. One of them obviously was the intake, and one was the exhaust. Aside from the acrylic used, we added some plastic snap-in nuts that the panels can be screwed into. The motherboard tray also had the holes threaded for standoffs, but nuts could have also been used to hold the standoffs in two. We added some screens to the framework to offer some dust control and some aesthetics, made it look a little bit better. We'll provide links in the description below to the additional stuff that we used. We cut the parts on a 120-watt Trotec laser. Given the thickness of the material used and the size of the parts, this should be cuttable in just about any laser, though. This would really include even small hobby lasers with much lower power and smaller bed sizes, like your typical Glowforge. So after we finished laser cutting the case, we wanted to make sure that things were going to fit together okay. So we just sort of dry fitting the pieces here. And yeah, there's paper mask on the acrylic. It wasn't peeled off yet, but before gluing, all that would be peeled off. Of course, we're going to have to take everything apart again and put it back together. So the case has already been glued together. We didn't show that. I'm just putting in these little plugs. The outer panels are going to be screwed into the framework here. Screws going through these little plugs just made it a little bit easier instead of having to be absolutely perfect and tap out the holes. You see there are screens that have already been added to act as filters for where the power supply unit that's going in now has its intake. And also there's one on the front for the intake into the case. There's one on the top. It's not really needed there, but it looks good because it is a more of a filter. And this is what it looks like when it's all put together. We didn't show the full assembly. So the other outer panels are attached here. Now, they were made out of clear acrylic, and we applied a called an air release vinyl. It was a matte white vinyl. You can just get it like on Amazon, or I think we'll have the links in the description below. And we actually put the panels back in the laser and let the laser cut the openings for the panels and do the vinyl. And the window is actually not a separate piece. The window you see on the side is really just the absence of vinyl in that area. So the laser just sort of scored the shape of the window, and then we just peeled the vinyl off that. And this is a better look at the framework with the computer components installed.
Thanks for watching. Let us know in the comments what you think and if you've ever thought about doing anything like this. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the bell to get notified of future projects.